All right, so this is part one of the weekly account audit. So here's the template report that we use to go through client accounts, to look at every aspect, make recommendations, analysis, and any strategy changes we need to make overall so we can tell the client, and also more importantly for us. I'm gonna be going all over all these aspects of the account. And I'll make a video for each single one of these modules so that we can always look back. So first things first, we're going to make a copy of this, the entire presentation. And you just name the client as the audit. So you put, in this case, this is the name of the client, Dream Firms Account Audit. And you put the date at the end. So in this case, it is the 11th. Now we put the company's name, client's name, and now we also put the date range. So I'll put, in this case of this audit, I'll put since June 1st. So 6-1, 2, 6-11-21. So about 2 weeks worth of data here. All right, the first part of this module is the overview. And this is very important because it gives a client a good idea of what the overview should be. So there's two different parts of this overview here. We have conversions, top campaigns, and little description analysis at the bottom. And also to note, the overview, after we do our analysis, we'll have another overview section that is just written. So it will just be, there'll be like a high level written overview, and the sections will compress up ads, landing pages, ads, landing pages, and next steps. So we'll have this as well, but this is done after. This is done after the initial analysis. But for the first part of the overview, we look at conversion rate and cost, top campaigns, cost per click, and then device breakdown. And the best and easiest place to get this data is from the overview report. So we use the same template report for all clients. We might add extra slides or remove slides depending on the client, but the template I shared with you, this is gonna have everything that you need that you can grab from data that you can grab directly from Google Ads and Google Analytics into Data Studio. So first things first, you wanna go in here and select the proper date range. So it'll be June 1st to here. Okay, you can see a good overview of the account, and you essentially just want to screenshot all of these and then make your actual analysis and breakdown for yourself, and then write it down so the client can know too. So we do a two-prong of you understanding and then the client understanding as well. So you just copy this, then we just remove this. Okay, oops, actually, we don't want click-through right here. We want to focus on conversions. We want to focus on high-level money-making things first. So copy conversions, put that in here. And then you want to grab the top campaigns next, which is down here. And one small edit to make as well. Actually, it's fine. I was going to say, if there's an ad group in here, you want to remove that. So just make sure you're on the same proper date range again. Okay. Grab the top campaigns here. Right, so we have these two different types of analysis on the first graphical overview page. So here we can say no conversions the last 14 days. Costs are increasing. The landing page is not converting. So that's something I know just from looking at the account, but all you can really do is make a high level view of the data and just say what it is. No conversions, cost is increasing. And you kind of just look at it for what it is, because in this overview here is where you kind of bring everything together. But for now, you just like interpret the data as what it is. If you know from the count why something is happening already, you can put that here. But mostly that's for this high level overview. And when you're actually speaking to the client, you can talk to it more. And I have some examples, so like just saying what the data is, just like writing it and putting it in plain English. So we can say for this, the 3-day Igniter Pro, Beta Pro. So I know this is a video campaign. Oops. Actually, this is a text campaign. The phrase match version campaign is getting the majority of clicks. And you want to bold any metrics at 24. Followed by the alpha campaign. And you just have to know how the account is structured and like how it's made. That's why usually it'll be an account either you made or I give you an audit of. But essentially, these are the two text campaigns. So the majority of our traffic is coming from highly relevant marketing for accountant search terms. Okay. And now we can look in here and see the next one. The video campaign has 18 clicks as well. So this basically just gives an overview analysis here. And now the next overview part, you're going to do pretty much the same thing, where you're going to be taking the cost per clicks, make sure the date range is good. So you can say the average cost per click has increased 272%. The last 2 weeks of cost was $475. Okay. And you can also put like a little snippet of information like more due to more competitors. That's something you can just really add there and just add upon it when you go to the other parts of the campaign, I mean of the deck. And last but not least of the overview, we want to go to device breakdown. So we can just see in this report. So 55% mobile. Wow, that's interesting. That's a pretty even breakdown. 40% desktop, 40% computers. So it's pretty even. It's almost like 40, 40, 40. 40% traffic coming from computers and 40% desktop, mobile. This is much higher. Desktop traffic could mean more business professionals. That's just something I would think of if more people are on desktops, because typically I would see like 90% mobile traffic. And the costs are split 80% between these two devices. And you just want to bold any numbers, really. That's good. So we basically have these two overviews. So you can dive in after you give your synopsis. People that want to see the graphs and the actual breakdown of numbers that can. And that's the first part of the overview.